إن هذا القرآن يهدي للتي هي أقوم ويبشر المؤمنين الذين يعملون الصالحات أن لهم أجرا كبيرا.
بسم الله، الحمد لله، والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله وعلى آله وصحبه ومن والاه، ما بعد. We are still doing Surah Ibrahim verse 22, and I said that this ayah is so profound it can be interpreted in different ways. Yesterday we followed one interpretation where the kalima tayyiba is that of la ilaha illallah, which is iman. Today we're going to move on to another interpretation which is mentioned by many ulama, including Ibn al-Jawzi and also the famous Mufassir Ibn Ashur. He said this interpretation, in his opinion, makes more sense. That is when Allah says, haven't you seen the example of the kalima tayyiba? Here he says the kalima tayyiba is the Quran itself, the speech of Allah. Because the Quran is the most beautiful speech, and it is the kalam of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So the kalima tayyiba is the Quran. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala then says, using this now analogy of the kalima tayyiba, that the kalima tayyiba is a beautiful tree. And the more you recite the Quran, the deeper it goes into the heart. And the more the Quran will be entrenched. And the more your love for the Quran and Iman will grow. كَشَجَرَةٍ طَيِّبَةٍ أَصْلُهَا ثَابِتٍ وَفَرْعُهَا فِي السَّمَاءِ. The Quran will raise you up. And this is in the hadith that our Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, that verily Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will raise up some people via this book. May Allah make us amongst them. And he shall debase other people. And we know from the hadith in Bukhari that our Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, it will be said to the companion of the Quran, sahib al-Quran, on the day of judgment, to recite and rise up. For every verse he recites, he will go one level higher. So the concept of rising up through the Quran, it is very explicit in the Quran and in the Sunnah. So here we have the example, therefore, of the Quran, that كَشَجَرَةٍ طَيِّبَةٍ أَصْلُهَا ثَابِتٌ وَفَرْعُهَا فِي السَّمَاءِ تُؤْتِي أُكُلَهَا كُلَّ حِينٍ. The Quran is giving you its fruits throughout the entire season. Anytime you need something, turn to the Quran, read the Quran, get the barakah of the Quran. If you're feeling sad, if you're feeling down, if you're feeling depressed, if you need any sabr, read the Quran and it will give you what you need. So this is the second interpretation, that the kalima tayyiba is the Quran. There is a third interpretation, which is a very small group, and there's nothing wrong with mentioning it. And they said that kalima tayyiba is any beautiful kalima. When you invite somebody to Islam, when you say a positive word, when you're following the sunnah by being cheerful and optimistic, so kalima tayyiba becomes a beautiful speech. Any beautiful speech. And when you interpret it this way, what Allah is therefore referencing is that when you speak good, then you are spreading good in people, and you're planting the seeds of optimism, and your good nature and your good words will impact other people, and they're going to be spreading these good news the way you're giving unto them these trees and these, So we say, for example, that in this case, the kalima tayyiba will spread its impact to other people. So this is three interpretations. Firstly, kalima tayyiba is la ilaha illallah, and this is the majority opinion. Secondly, kalima tayyiba is the Quran, and there are many ulama who said this. And then thirdly, some ulama said kalima tayyiba is any good word, and all three of these meanings are valid. Now the next verse flips it around, and Allah says, وَمَثَلُ كَلِمَةٍ خَبِيثَ. The example of a filthy kalima. What is the filthy kalima? It depends on how you interpreted the pure kalima. If you said the kalima tayyiba is la ilaha illallah, the filthy kalima is the kalima of shirk. It is people calling to other than Allah. If you interpret the kalima tayyiba as the Quran, the filthy kalima is anything that is meant to reject the Quran, any type of ideology or methodology that is meant to negate the Quran. So Allah says, وَمَثَلُ كَلِمَةٍ خَبِيثَ. The example or the parable of a filthy kalima, كَشَجَرَةٍ خَبِيثَ, like an evil tree, a tree that is thorny, prickly, no leaves, no flowers, no fruits. Nobody likes such a tree. كَشَجَرَةٍ خَبِيثَ أُجُتُثَّتْ مِنْ فَوْقِ الْأَرْضِ. It has been cut off from on top of the earth. It has no roots. It's not going to be stable. It will not give you stability, nor will it provide stability in your life. So if you follow other than the kalima tayyiba, if you follow other than the Quran, you will not be entrenched, you will not be solidified, you will not be anchored. You will have a tree that is filthy, that is discarded, that has no roots. اُجْدُثَّتْ مِنْ فَوْقِ الْأَرْضِ مَا لَهَا مِنْ قَرَارِ. It has no stability on the earth. So when you have the kalima tayyiba, you have stability. You are anchored. You know where you are. You know your purpose. When the trials of life and the tribulations of life come, when the winds of change come, you have iman. You're rock solid. You have the kalima tayyiba. When you don't have the kalima tayyiba, you are like some type of branches or bushes that are not implanted in the earth. When the winds of change come, when the winds of fitna come, you will go with the winds wherever they go. مَا لَهَا مِنْ قَرَارٍ. You have no stability. So subhanAllah, when you have iman and when you have the Qur'an, it provides stability in your life. It's like literally a magnet. It's like a strong tree that roots you in the ground. You are firm despite all the changes happening. When you don't have the kalima tayyiba, you don't have la ilaha illallah, you don't have the Qur'an, then you will panic at anything. You will not have the peace. You will not have the itmi'nan. And you will be like that tree that everybody discards. And then Allah says, يُثَبِّتُ اللَّهُ الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا بِالْقَوْلِ الثَّابِتِ فِي الْحَيَاةِ الدُّنْيَا وَفِي الْآخِرَةِ. Allah Azza wa Jal will make firm, يُثَبِّت. Allah will make firm with the قول الثابت. Now again, what is the قول الثابت? Either لا إله إلا الله or the Quran, depending on how you interpret the kalima tayyiba. Allah will make firm the people of iman with the kalima or with the Quran, depending on how you interpret it. So if you have the kalima, Allah will reinforce and Allah will make it firm. When? في الحياة الدنيا وفي الآخرة. What does this mean? Ibn Abbas said, فِي الْحَيَاةِ الدُّنْيَا, in this world, means when a person is going to leave this dunya, Allah will bless him to say the kalima tayyiba when he leaves. May Allah make the last phrase we say, لا إله إلا الله محمد رسول الله. Our Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم said, whoever says لا إله إلا الله as his last breath shall enter Jannah. How can we guarantee that? We cannot guarantee that. But Allah is telling us, if we are firm to the kalima tayyiba, and if we are loyal to it, then Allah is saying, I will make it firm for you. And before you leave this dunya, يُثَبِّتُ اللَّهُ الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا. I will bless you to say the kalima tayyiba فِي الْحَيَاةِ الدُّنْيَا. And then, وَفِي الْآخِرَةِ, in the hereafter as well. When is the hereafter? Ibn Abbas said, when Munkar and Nakir come to you, and they ask you the questions, who will give you the answer? Allah, يُثَبِّتُ اللَّهُ الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا. Allah will give you the answer. And Allah will allow you to answer when you are in the qabr. So this ayah talks to us about being affirmed by the kalima tayyiba. Again, what is the kalima tayyiba? Either la ilaha illallah or the Qur'an. Is there any contradiction? If we say either la ilaha or the Qur'an, is there any contradiction? No, because the Qur'an and la ilaha illallah are the same thing. It is the Quran that teaches us la ilaha illallah, and la ilaha illallah is explained via the teachings of the Quran. So these two interpretations are both valid. And Allah Azza wa Jalla is giving us a beautiful metaphor. So I encourage you to go back to these verses and understand them in light of this brief explanation, and then ask yourself, don't you want to be amongst those whom Allah will affirm, whom Allah will strengthen? يُثَبِّتُ اللَّهُ الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا بِالْقَوْلِ الثَّابِتِ. In this world, فِي الْحَيَاةِ الدُّنْيَا وَفِي الْآخِرَةِ. If you do, then turn to the kalima, study the kalima, say the kalima, learn the Qur'an, memorize the Qur'an, recite the Qur'an, and then inshaAllah ta'ala, when our time comes, Allah will make us firm, and Allah will give us thabat, and we'll be able to say the kalima when we leave, and we'll be able to answer the questions of Munkar and Nakir in the grave. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give us that thabat, and we'll continue tomorrow. Wassalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.